Hot Hit It tonight when Jodi Anasta joins the cast of the globally successful soapy. She's promising to shake things up in Erinsborough as the feisty Ellie Conway. Let's welcome Jodi to Studio 10. Woo! How does it feel to be back on the box on a soapy?
I know, it's so exciting. Yeah. I can't wait to see what people think of Ellie. I know it's going to be a little bit of a shock, but yeah, she's quite an interesting character. Especially the first episode, it's quite full on, jam-packed with lots of naughty little things. Oh. But yeah,
be careful more? Because Ash just told us that he was very naughty earlier in the show.
Oh really?
Yeah. Yes, be careful. Really?
I was. Also, take yourself in, Jodi.
Oh, yes.
I think Ash might be angling for a cameo on Neighbours. I think.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I was actually. I was second in Mr. Erinsborough. Seriously?
Really?
About 10 years ago.
What's that,
Mr. Erinsborough? It's a stripping competition.
Of course it is.
Was it at Lassiter's?
Lassiter's. Yeah. Say, how dare you? Don't give me that. It was a classy event. And
did you say you came second?
Came second.
Sorry, you lost me there. No.
I think I lost a total.
My sister was actually also in Neighbours, believe it or not, and played the highly powerful and pivotal role of girl who passes out in nightclub.
Oh, really? Because,
yeah, she was getting some dodgy prescription drugs from not Dr. Carl, but it was someone else, evil doctor, and Dr. Carl. But anyway.
What is it like coming home? Because I remember the night, I remember watching you when you won Best New Talent at the Logies. You were is it like coming home to work on another soapy?
There is that sense of kind of coming home and getting to know all those old feelings and getting restructured back into that kind of soap world and that way of kind of being on set, learning and acting and then coming home, learning more scripts while you're making dinner and driving for dinner and learning a script. And it's like just that whole world of soap again.
You did some brushing up, didn't you, for this role? Did you do some acting classes or some polishing up classes?
I did a little bit of that. A lot of practicing and kind of learning lines again and how to retain that information. Yeah. And then I did a lot of character work as well. My character's quite complex. So many different layers, so much fun. So challenging to play this character. And then I've added my own little spin on her and I feel like I'm getting there. After about 10 weeks of filming, I feel like I've got a really good grasp on who she is and just how far I can push her as a character.
Oh, good on you. Mm. And it's so important, I think, to have a passion for what you do.
Yes.
And obviously one of your passions is being a mum.
Yes.
We see beautiful pictures of your darling little girl.
She's getting so big.
And she's the sweetest pea. She's got the most divine smile.
And her personality, she's so vivacious. And she'll be at dinner with me and my friends and she'll have the entire table crying with laughter. Aww. She has that ability and she's 2.5 years old. Aww. I'm like, okay, I feel really proud and I'm watching everyone nearly crying over laughing at her. And she dances and she's just running around the house and talking nonstop.
So what does she say when she sees you on television?
Mama.
How do you go with all of that, that balance? Because obviously you're filming in Melbourne.
Yes.
How do you go with the juggle?
It's, it's tough not seeing her during the week. It definitely is. But when I auditioned for Neighbours, I kind of said to them, in my selfish way, I said, my daughter comes first. You know, you have to understand that being a single parent, I need, you know, she is my priority. Yeah. So they kind of restructured it. So they managed to fit an entire week's of filming into a few days for me. Mm. So I could fly to Melbourne, do my work, and then fly back to Sydney to be with my daughter. So I feel like that says a lot about their family values in itself. And it's really nice to work for a company who support you in that way. Yes.
And I think it's not selfish to say that. I think good on you for speaking up, saying this is what is important for me and my family.
Yeah,
because more women need to do that. So good on you.
And it is difficult to kind of want your career and you want to be a great mum and you know, for some people you want to be a good partner, everything. So to kind of juggle that all and do it in the right way it's a touchy subject, but it's worth fighting for.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Now, did you actually have to audition for this role?
Yes.
Really?
I put on
did
my
you
best.
Did you say hello, Logie? You know?
No, it was quite daunting because I haven't done anything in a long time. I was like 30 minutes deciding which coloured dress to wear, you know.
Was the process weird and nervous?
So nerve-wracking.
Wow.
Especially when they say, oh, you're down to the final three, fly to Melbourne and we'll audition you with your castmate or future husband, whatever you want to call it. And it's really daunting. You kind of have 5 minutes to shine. And my audition was terrible. I forgot my lines. Every time I did something, I forgot my lines. But you know what? I think it's about embodying your character and having the essence of what they want. Mm. And if that comes through, then you're all good.
And you light up the screen. I mean, you're stunning. Oh, so you do.
It's called luminize the desk.
I need some.
Well, we actually just saw some footage before, Jodi. You are stunning. Can we play that again upstairs? It was wonderful footage. This is fantastic.
Is that you in the background with the man bun?
You know what?
Yes. Oh my gosh.
Here we go. They're fantastic.
So this is your first introduction?
Yes.
This part,
I will have Ali's eyes closed.
Definitely. This is why Ash wants to come on the show.
He always takes his top off on the show, so, you know.
Funny you went to that part.
Well, it's acting. It's acting. I don't know why these guys are laughing. I like the acting. And
what part of it did you like?
I like the character arc.
Well, you can see Jodi in action tonight on Neighbours at 6:30 on 11. Jodi Anasta, welcome home. Yeah.